Dinosaurs were some of the largest and most impressive animals to have ever lived in the history of life on Earth. Their size alone inspires awe in all that witnessed their massive skeletons. And of these massive animals, they were none larger or more impressive than the Titanosaurs, colossal titans that reach near mythical sizes. One of such monumental animals thrived in the ancient forests of what would one day become Argentina. Reaching an impressive 26 meters in length and weighing nearly 50 tons, this animal would have been almost invincible. Living at a time when large sauropods were becoming obsolete in South America, this titanosaur stood out as being one of the last great sauropods of the dinosaur age. Standing far above all of his predators, this was Dreadnoughtus, the colossus that feared nothing. The discovery of Dreadnoughtus goes as far back as 2005, when American paleontologist Kenneth Lacovera first discovered gigantic bones belonging to a sauropod found in a companion Mistrician age rocks of the Cerro Fortaleza formation, located in the Santa Cruz province of Patagonia, Argentina. Since the bones uncovered were so large, it took the excavation team quite some time to finally remove and transport the fossils, which took 4 Austrian summers to successfully field jacket the bones, get them out of the rock, and load it into a truck. After the fossils were transported, it was confirmed by the team that about 145 bones were recovered along with a single tooth. The fossil material then arrived at the Carnegie Museum of Natural History, where the fossils were cleaned and prepped for examination until 2012. The remains were then scanned by a technology device called Next Engine 3D Laser Scanner, which helped scan and document the structure of the fossils in order to create a construction. With the help of the scanner, they were able to create a digitally connected skeleton. In 2014, after the material was analyzed, Kenneth identified not one, but 2 specimens of a brand new genus of giant titanosaurian sauropod. For the name, Kenneth thought about what this large sauropod had to fear in its environment. Kenneth, with this question in mind, named the new titanosaur as Dreadnoughtus strani, with his generic name meaning fear nothing, named after the old English word from the 20th century dreadnought. And the species name is in honor of Adam Strawn, who helped support the research. The holotype given the catalog, MPMPV1156, consists of many fossil fragments, some of which being a maxilla fragment, multiple dorsal vertebrae, ribs, and a right tibia, just to name a few. With a good amount of these fragments including a partial anterior cervical vertebrae, 7 caudal vertebrae, as well as 5 hemal arches. The paratype MPMPV3546 also consists of many different bones. With a good amount of these fragments including a partial anterior cervical vertebra, 7 caudal vertebrae, as well as 5 hemal arches. With so many remains uncovered from those 2 specimens, it is now considered to be the most complete titanosaur to have ever been unearthed. About 45.3% of the total skeletal anatomy is complete, along with postcranial elements being about 70.4%. In comparison to other large titanosaurs, according to the 2014 publication, Futalongosaurus has about 7.3% and 12.7% of fossil material. Prelatitan has about 7.8% and 12.7%. Argentinosaurus, one of the largest titanosaurs on record, is only about 5.1% and 9.2%. The least complete of the titanosaurs listed is Portosaurus, which this titanosaur only contains about 1.6% and 2.8%. As a result, Dreadnoughtus is a more informative titanosaur than any other members that rivaled its size. Because of its overall completeness, Dreadnoughtus is able to give many paleontologists a huge amount of information for future studies on how these massive animals evolved, thrived, and moved anatomically. One other thing worth noting is that the holotype is not fully grown due to bone features, such as its scapula being unfused. Other parts of the skeleton, in addition, lack lines of growth, indicating that this animal could have grown much larger than the fossils we currently have. Hopefully with more fossil finds, we will be able to uncover an adult Dreadnoughtus specimen and find out just how massive these titanosaurs could have gotten. Dreadnoughtus is one of the largest sauropods to have ever lived. Based on the current estimates we have, Dreadnoughtus strani length is estimated to be a total of 85 feet or 26 meters, with its head to the base of its neck accounting for about 40 feet or 12.2 meters, and the tail itself being approximately 29 feet or 8.7 meters. The titanosaur also has a total shoulder height of about 21 feet or 6.4 meters. And finally, the total mass of this huge sauropod is about 65 tons or 59.3 metric tons. While Dreadnoughtus is indeed a huge sauropod, it could have also been rivaled by its neighboring titanosaur, Portosaurus. Though the full size of this titanosaur is still being debated due to a lack of fossil material, it's suggested that this sauropod may have measured at about 30 meters or 98 feet in length, and possibly weighing between 45 and 55 tons, which is around the same size range of Paticotitan. However, one thing worth noting is that the current size estimates we have for Dreadnoughtus are based on the biggest specimen that was still growing, meaning that they could potentially get far larger, though it is uncertain how big they can actually get. Hopefully in time, we will be able to uncover some more fossil material to tell us just how big these magnificent animals truly got. Dreadnoughtus is a member of Titanosauria, one of the longest-lasting clades of the long-neck sauropods. Titanosaurs overall were extremely diverse and came in many different shapes and sizes, as their fossil record goes as far back as the Barryacian-Valaginian boundary of the early Cretaceous, with their ancestors first appearing in the late Jurassic. The Titanosaur lineage not only contains famous dinosaurs like Argentinosaurus, one of the largest land animals to have ever walked the planet, but their diversity also brought the rise of some of the smallest sauropods ever discovered. These include Eastern Europe's Megarosaurus and Brazil's Iburania. During the latter half of the Cretaceous, South America was under the dominion of the sauropods. While rather diverse in groups, larger sizes became rare by the time Dreadnoughtus existed. In 2014, Dreadnoughtus was positioned as a derived basal member of Titanosauria, whilst not exactly branched within the clade Lizostratia. In its publication, the remains known from Dreadnoughtus retain both primitive and advanced features, making its true placement uncertain. However, a 2016 study found that Dreadnoughtus has many characteristics akin to Lizostratia, especially the genera Aeolosaurus and Gondwana Titan, suggesting that Dreadnoughtus might actually be a basal member of the South American clade Aeolosaurinae. Thanks to this discovery, the authors offer to further investigate the relationships between all three genera in future cladistics analysis. Hopefully in the future, more cladistics and phylogenetic research can give us a better understanding of where Dreadnoughtus exactly sits within Lizostratia. Dreadnoughtus is known to live in the Cerro Fortaleza formation, a formation situated in Argentina that dates from the late Campanian to the early Maastrichtian of the late Cretaceous period. South America during this time has shallow seas covering northern Patagonia, northeastern Argentina, and Bolivia. As for the climate, the southern region Dreadnoughtus inhabited was also very temperate and humid. The environment itself was lush and verdant with vegetation along with a mixture of forests and rivers. The flora that blossom in its environment consists of conifer trees like Copresoxylon, the long-lasting Agathoxylon, and many others along with flowery plants like Hedycarioxylon. The conifer trees that dominated this region were ideal for giant sauropods like Dreadnoughtus as they were high browsers. The behavior of this titanosaur is not currently known, but it's suggested that Dreadnoughtus was likely a social herbivore moving throughout the forests and plains. As these giant titanosaurs thrive in their highly vegetated homes, they are not the only herbivores that inhabited these regions. Dreadnoughtus lived alongside another giant titanosaur, Portosaurus. Since both Portosaurus and Dreadnoughtus were both giant sauropods that rivaled each other in size, it's not impossible to believe that they may have competed and fought for the same food source. Aside from sauropods, the only other herbivorous dinosaur known from this formation is the ornithopod Talancawan. Considering the small size, Talancawan was no competitor to the mighty giants as it was more than likely a low-browsing herbivore, and therefore could coexist. As an adult, Dreadnoughtus was more likely a relatively harmless animal that would spend most of its lifetime feeding, in a similar vein to most other large animals. As to our current knowledge, it has no predators to fear due to its massive size. However, hatchlings and juveniles would have been easy prey for theropods like the Megaraptor and Orcaraptor, and another theropod known as Ostrochirus. They also likely fell prey to pyrosauric crocodilians whenever they needed to drink or cross a river. While turtles were no target to sauropods, they still had to worry about getting trampled by larger individuals, as there's evidence of a sauropod hind limb tract that preserved a crushed turtle shell which was found in a different formation. Once the sauropods reached a decent size as subadults and then adulthood, they basically had nothing to fear since they would use their huge size to keep predators from attacking them. However, since the formation it lived in doesn't have enough data to completely reconstruct its natural environment, there is likelihood that there was a larger theropod present in Cerro Fortaleza, and if there was a large theropod that was specialized with hunting larger prey items, Dreadnoughtus did have a weapon for defense, that being his 30-foot-long muscular tail. According to La Covera, it's possible that this tail, thanks to this musculature, would provide a powerful leverage. If Dreadnoughtus swung this tail fast enough, the attacker would be severely injured. With his huge size and powerful tail, Dreadnoughtus' heavily built structure was enough to defend itself if anything tried hunting it. Dreadnoughtus overall was an animal that was extremely valuable to his ecosystem. Titans like these keep balancing the populations of the many tall trees they fed on. If that's not all, if these sauropods died from a sickness, a drought, an attack, or other unrelated injuries, the remaining corpse would be a valuable food source to predators from miles around, scavenging on a carcass until there was nothing left. In death, the giant sauropods like Dreadnoughtus play a similar role to the carcasses of whales feeding sharks in our oceans today. Since its discovery, Dreadnoughtus has made a fair share of appearances in various media. Starting in 2016, it made its debut in the mobile game Jurassic Park Builder, where it was featured as a limited-time tournament creature that could have also been bought in the Jurassic Pack. 2 years later, in 2018, it will make an appearance in Jurassic World Play and show up in Jurassic World Evolution as part of the Cretaceous Dinosaur DLC pack. Later, Dreadnoughtus would appear in its sequel game, Jurassic World Evolution 2, in 2021. For the next 2 years, it would appear in Jurassic World Alive as a rare creature in 2022, and in 2023, it would be featured in Jurassic World The Game as another limited-time creature. It was also revealed that Dreadnoughtus will eventually be added into Ark Survival Ascended as part of the Extinction DLC. As for documentaries, other TV shows and films, Dreadnoughtus made its debut just under a year after its description in 2015 docufilm Top 10 Biggest Beasts Ever. In 2016, it appeared in the Netflix-exclusive children's series Dino Trucks, being dubbed as a rare species known as Dread Trucks. In the same year, Dreadnoughtus would make an appearance in another children's show, 2009's Dinosaur Train. It then appeared in a 2018 documentary series Drain the Oceans in Episode 3 of Season 6 titled Secrets of the Dinosaurs. Dreadnoughtus later get its own dedicated segment in the 2022-2023 docuseries Prehistoric Planet, being shown in the first season's second episode titled Deserts as two males are seen fighting for the right to mate. Interestingly, this was its debut in a nature documentary. The latest paleomedia Dreadnoughtus appeared in just less than a month after its appearance in Prehistoric Planet was in the Hollywood blockbuster Jurassic World Dominion, the sixth theoretical entry to the Jurassic film franchise. As it stands now, Dreadnoughtus is a fairly well-known creature, but hopefully this massive sauropod will be featured in more media as the years go on. Dreadnoughtus was indeed a fascinating sauropod of its time. It is known for having a more complete skeleton than any other titanosaur, and it had nothing to fear in its environment as a full-grown adult. However, like most other animals, no species lasts forever. And sadly, this huge behemoth went extinct 70 million years ago at the dawn of the Maastrichtian stage. However, the cause of its extinction is currently unknown. It may have been brought on by climatic or environmental changes, though with only two specimens known from Cerro Fortaleza. It's not known how widespread these sauropods were, and if they even made it to the end of the Maastrichtian. Titanosaurs as a group would push forward after Dreadnoughtus disappeared in the fossil record, only going completely extinct by the end of the Maastrichtian, as the meteor that killed them wiped out a lineage that spans over 160 million years, marking the end of the age of dinosaurs. While Dreadnoughtus and his kind may be gone, the fossil remains they left behind shows us that even life on land had no bounds to the sizes they could reach. And even though many large animals may have taken their place as giants of their own, life on land will never again reach the heights of Dreadnoughtus, the colossus that feared nothing. Thank you all for watching our video covering the mighty Dreadnoughtus. We really enjoyed making this one and hope you all enjoyed watching it. This massive sauropod is an underlooked titanosaur in comparison to his relatives and deserves as much coverage as it can get. This video was directed and narrated by myself, MikeMC9797, scripted by myself, The Primal Earth, CrimsonAcro, RangoGamer, and SpinoDragon145, edited by myself, The Primal Earth, CrimsonAcro, LegitEliminator, and Straight Up Murph. The graphic designers for this video were Straight Up Murph for creature design, The Dinosaur Hunter for the thumbnail, and Mephilas Seijin101 for the model and animation. And finally, the researchers for this video were myself, CrimsonAcro, and SpinoDragon145. As always, be sure to leave a like and comment down below what you'd like to see for future videos. And then subscribe and hit the notification video to be notified of future videos when they release. And with that, we will see you all next time on Epoch Now.